I request everybody to mute your microphone so that only me and Umang should be audible. ये तो सबके घर के सब बर्तन वर्तन के आवाज आएंगे, कुकर के आवाज आएंगे, वो नहीं होना चाहिए. आई होप इट्स एक्सेप्ट यू एंड मी, ऑल आर ऑन म्यूट. कूल. सो शुड वी, इट्स 5:29.
लेट्स वेट फॉर 2 मिनट्स मोर एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट.
कलेक्शन. ओके, रेस्ट आर द बुक्स आर अक्रॉस माई हाउस एंड दिस आई कॉल इट एज बुकलेट हाउस वेर वी वर्क फॉर बुकलेट फ्रॉम योर. इट्स पार्ट ऑफ माई हाउस बट कन्वर्टेड इन टू एन ऑफिस सेटअप. Most of the books are either borrowed or gifted by all the people who are part of the mission. Hi guys, I'm Amrut Deshmukh, your booklet guy, and I'm sure you are very keen to know what are the tricks, what are the habits that I have cultivated so that I could read so many books. As you know that we are now more than 15 lakh people as part of this mission, Make India Read. And CACS Umang Ratani has been kind enough to make this private session open up to everybody, to all the readers of Mission Make India Read. So thank you so much, Ratan, for this kind gesture. And I think hundreds of people are joining on YouTube. Since I probably believe that Booklet Guy is not a brand, Booklet Guy is not a celebrity. Booklet Guy is a spirit. A spirit that believes books can make us think differently, and a strong belief that if I'm not reading, I'm not changing, and if I'm not changing, I'm not growing, right? And because of this strong belief, I have a burning desire to cultivate the habit of reading amongst the youth of India, and hence I'm on a mission called Make India Read. In line with this, the objective or the purpose of my life, I have written this book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective Readers. Yeah, can you see? Yeah. The 7 Habits of Highly Effective Readers, not people, not written by Stephen Covey. I adapted this book from Stephen Covey because he's one of my favorite authors. And I owe 80% of success of booklet Mission Make India Read to Stephen Covey, who is the author of The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. So, my favorite hobby is to keep experimenting with my reading life. Till now, I have read almost 1000 uploaded on Booklet app in text and audio form both. Today, we are going to discuss all the experiments that I have conducted with my reading life. Few failed, few were successful, to find out the solutions to all the reading problems. The most common question that I get when I keep traveling across the world to spread the mission is that, Amrut, should we read books in the morning or in the night? What is the right time to read? I have a guilt that, I don't read. I lose interest on page number 20 because and then I feel guilty that I'm a bad reader. So the first habit out of all the 7 habits is, surprisingly, don't take reading too seriously. Okay, now I'll tell you why. See, habits are casual. All habits are casual, and because they are casual, they are habitual. You take any habit, be it chatting on WhatsApp, driving, watching TV. Do you take them very seriously? Of course not. Will you ask that, what is the right time to chat on WhatsApp? Is it morning or evening? Definitely not, right? So if something is important to you, don't make it special, make it casual, because habits are casual, right? So when somebody asks me that, I lose interest after reading few pages and then I feel that I am a bad. So even I had the guilt that I am a bad reader or I'm a slow reader. I used to leave many books half read. In fact, I have left hundreds of books half read, but now I don't feel guilty about it because I transferred the onus, the responsibility to the author to keep me engaged, to keep me excited, to keep me hooked to the book. It's not all your fault if you lose interest in the book. Because will you say that after watching the pathetic movie of Aamir Khan, Thugs of Hindustan, which I left in the interval because it was so horrible, will you say that, arre, wo picture maine adhura chhod diya, I think I insulted Aamir Khan. Yeah, I am a bad movie watcher. Do you say this? That now this sounds really funny, right? So, but when it comes to books, we take all the responsibility, I am a bad reader. No, it is also the responsibility of the author to keep you engaged, right? With due respect to all the authors, my intention is not to insult the authors because of them, I am here as booklet guy. Yeah. But if you pass on the onus to the author, you don't feel guilty about it. And then even if you quit the book, you don't quit reading. So the books will get replaced with pages. Yeah. I understand the old adage that don't judge the book by its cover, but you can judge it after reading 10 pages. Yes or no? Yeah. And getting a book nowadays is not a big deal. Okay. You can borrow, you just put a comment on WhatsApp status that I'm looking for this book. Is somebody having this? If yes, can you please lend it to me? I bet within 1 week the book will be in your hands, provided the lockdown is passed. You can listen to booklet. So the first habit is don't take reading too seriously. Yeah. And then half of the questions will be disappeared. Now, many people ask me that I don't remember what I read. Yeah. I often observe many of my friends, especially girls, what they do is when they open the book, they start reading with a pen, pencil, rubber, scale, and an orange highlighter, fluorescent wala, green highlighter, sab leke baithenge padhne ko, yeah, and then they will highlight so much, yeah, on each page that the non-highlighted part looks like highlighted, right? Now you don't remember things by decorating the book. The best way to remember what you read is to read and discuss. And that's what we don't do. You know, we are so busy into gossiping and all those Santa Banta jokes, criticizing the bosses. I think 70% of words that come out of our mouth, vision and enthusiasm, the other person gets the curiosity. Hello, ye to ek idea agar itna exciting hai, to book mein kya hoga? Right? And then he will insist to lend that book to him. You give it the book to him. He will read and then come out with few points that you must have skipped or forgotten, and this is how you do justice to the book, right? And then you have revisited the book without rereading. I'm not against rereading. Of you are free to read the book for the second time, but there is a better solution, right? And then when you get the book back from your friend and you lend it to another friend and another and another, and the book travels through 10 different hands within your friend circle, and a book goes completely out of shape where the pages are torn out. Yeah, so all the side notes and scribbling. Yeah, for me, that is the most beautiful book in the world. Right? For me, it is not the book which is decorated in red ribbons in the crossword. That's not a beautiful book. The book which is out of shape because of its overuse. And I think the author of that book will be the happiest person on planet Earth. Is it not? So, many people say that I don't remember everything. The point is, let us try to understand the difference between learning and studying. We study in academics, we study in schools, we study in colleges. What I'm talking about is, in Marathi, we call it as avantar vachan. There is no great such phrase in English or Hindi. Avantar vachan means general reading, which is out of syllabus reading, right? And here we have to learn and not study. We learn cooking, we learn driving, right? We learn to play piano. We don't study cooking, we don't study driving, right? So we have to learn. So you are not going to be tested on the information that you learn from a general book. Then you have done justice to the book. You have to get the big picture. In fact, habit number 4 is get the big picture. Skip the details. Right? If I think that I read Rich Dad Poor Dad like a decade ago. Okay. One big thing that I still remember is the difference between passive income and active income. Yeah, why rich become richer? They focus on passive income. They create systems which generate cash for them. Whereas poor people remain poor because they focus on active income. They have to start from zero every month. Now, this was something game changing and struck me so hard. I kept on discussing this idea with so many people that now it has become part of my character. Okay. So, retention is overrated. The more you talk about it, something which is on the top of the mind has to be on the top tip of your tongue. And when you keep talking about it, you know, it becomes part of your character and you don't know that ye book, ye idea maine kahin padha tha, kaun se book mein padha tha, that is not important. As far as aajkal itna busy life, you know, office, ghar ka kaam, main bolta hu ki boss, nobody is busy in life, it's all about priorities. Yeah? If you have time for Facebook, you have time for a book. Now, if you are really busy in life, Facebook would have been a big flop, isn't it? Facebook ke liye time hai, to book ke liye time hai, bhai. Right? So, when reading became the top priority of my life and of the day, then I started finding value in those small source pockets during the day. Because of the lockdown, many people started requesting me that Amrut, make a video and tell everybody, appeal to everybody that start reading. Now you have a lot of time at home. I did not make such video because I don't want to give a false message to the people that to read, you need extra time. You need to take out time from your schedule. Aisa nahi karna hai, right? Do you take out time for breakfast? Do you take out time to watch TV? Do you take out time for lunch and dinner? No, they are integral part of your daily routine. And I want you to make reading an integral part of your daily routine. Because once the lockdown is over, then books will go out of your life. Aisa nahi hona chahiye, right? So, what are those? This habit number 2 is filling your time pockets. So, I'm at a dentist clinic. 4 patients are waiting before me. So, instead of just watching their sad faces, I take out a book and read 3 pages. That's all. Okay. I'm standing in the queue at the railway station, just watching at the dandruff of the person standing next to me like a zombie. No, I just take out a book and read a couple of pages. There are so many small time pockets that you don't even realize they just evaporate. They evaporate like nothing. Yeah, we just mindlessly spend them or waste them. You're waiting at the bus stop and 10-15 minutes are, the bus arrives after 10 minutes. We are just watching here and there. एयरपोर्ट पे हमको 2 घंटा पहुंचना मजबूरी है, राइट? सो मेनी ऑफ माय बुक्स हैव गॉट बुकमार्क्स व्हिच आर बोर्डिंग पासेस ऑफ द फ्लाइट, या सो ऑफ कोर्स इवन आई डिड ऑल दीज मिस्टेक्स ऑफ यू नो वेस्टिंग ऑल दोस टाइम पॉकेट्स, बट व्हेन आई कैलकुलेटेड एंड मेड एन एडिशन ऑफ ऑल दीज स्मॉल पॉकेट्स ड्यूरिंग द डे, इट केम टू 60 to 90 minutes पर डे. 60 to 90 minutes. इवन इफ यू फिल अप 50% of these time pockets during the day, you will finish a 200 to 300 pages book in 1 week. See, it's that simple without taking out separate time for reading. Yeah, I agree that people say in the morning time, as per scientific research, morning time is ideal for reading. I tried this, but then it backfired that if I fail to read a few pages in the morning, I get a valid reason not to read for the rest of the day. तो वो काम नहीं करता है. ओके, आई हैव टू कैरी माय बुक, एंड इफ यू कांट कैरी योर बुक, ओके, इट प्रैक्टिकली यू कांट कैरी योर बुक एवरीवेयर, या फाइन, द गैमेट ऑफ रीडिंग हैज एक्सपैंडेड नाउ. रीड रैंडम आई डू नॉट मीन ओनली रैंडम जॉनर्स, बट रैंडम प्लेटफॉर्म्स. यू कैन रीड पीडीएफ, यू कैन लिसन टू पॉडकास्ट. द गैमेट ऑफ रीडिंग हैज एक्सपैंडेड नाउ. या वी कांट इंसिस्ट अ 6-year, 10-year-old किड टू हैव अ बुक इन हैंड स्टाइल ऑफ रीडिंग. Because they don't know the beauty of that, you know, the smell of that brand new book, you know, then the pages turning yellow as the book gets older. अचानक से वो एक फूल का एक पत्ता हमको मिल जाता है बुक के अंदर, अचानक से एक 10 रुपए का नोट मिल जाता है. इवन दो ये सब इमोशनल करते हैं हमको, बट ऑल दीज थिंग्स हैव नथिंग टू डू विद रीडिंग हैबिट, राइट? दे आर जस्ट इमोशनल पार्ट ऑफ आवर लाइफ. So these kids, if we are technology migrant, these kids are technology native. They are born younger ones to, you know, have a hard copy in book, and let's expand. Because thanks to the internet, you know, it has become disruptive. The reading and music industry has been disrupted by the internet. So even if you have a PDF in your mobile, you can just open it and read wherever you are. Yeah, it is location independent. All right. So as I said, that if you lose interest after some pages, maybe the whole objective of the book was to tell you what kind of books you should not read. Right? Again, I'm transferring the onus to the author. That okay, ye book mere liye nahi hai. Quit it. Yeah. Okay. I'll try to convince you in a different analogy that why we take reading too seriously or books too seriously. Imagine that there is a guy who has come as a speaker in a seminar, but he's lacking the charisma, the enthusiasm, and he's wo paka raha hai aapko. He's not coming to the point. He's just wandering away and off the topic. Aur to aap kya bologe aapke dost ko? अरे यार क्या पका रहा है यार, चल ना ब्रेक लेके आते, या फिर आप अपना व्हाट्सएप निकाल के उस पर टाइम पास करोगे, राइट? बट इफ द सेम पर्सन राइट्स अ बुक, यू हैव टू रीड वर्ड टू वर्ड. सो आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? द मैसेज इज सेम, ओनली द मीडियम इज चेंजिंग. ओके, व्हेन द गाय स्पीकिंग वी फाइंड, इफ यू डिड नॉट लाइक स्पीकर के भाषण पे हम ताली नहीं बजाते, अगर नहीं अच्छा लगा तो हम ताली नहीं बजाएंगे. बट व्हेन द सेम गाय राइट्स अ बुक, we take so seriously. Yeah, see, only the medium is changing, the message is same, the same person will write the same thing with what he was speaking in his speech, but our approach is changing completely. See, so through these examples, what I'm trying to tell you is, jyada seriously mat lo reading ko. Jitna casual karoge, utna aapko, jitne rules kam rakhoge, utna books aapke zindagi mein zinda rahenge. Right? So, these are the some rules that I'm trying to break, rules that we, I don't know from where these rules came, that you can't read 2-3 books at a time. Yeah, 3-4 serials TV ke dekhte ho na saath mein, to tabhi wo jumbling hota hai ki ek serial ka dusre serial mein story jata hai ki uska, nahi na. So I read Harry Potter and Chanakya Niti at the same time. I have read Robin Sharma's Bonk His Soul His Ferrari and biography of Shivaji at the same time, right? And the best part of it is when you read such random books, you know, the accumulated knowledge from these random books help you to find some dynamic correlations, and in that randomness you come out with some great innovative ideas, right? And again, I would like to repeat that even if you learn 1, 2, or 3 big ideas from a book, you are done. Don't try to overdo, don't try to remember everything from the book. It is impossible to remember everything from the book. Only something that excites you, ओके ये कुछ अलग है, या देन अपने आप वो याद रहेगा. ओके, टेल मी व्हाट इज मोर बेनिफिशियल, लर्निंग 10% फ्रॉम 10 डिफरेंट बुक्स और 100% फ्रॉम 1 बुक? आई एम श्योर यू विल से दैट 10% फ्रॉम 10 डिफरेंट बुक्स, राइट? बिकॉज आई एम गेटिंग एक्सपोज टू 10 डिफरेंट एक्सपर्ट ब्रेन्स, राइट, इंस्टेड ऑफ जस्ट 100% फ्रॉम 1 एक्सपर्ट ब्रेन, राइट? So again, I am saying, because we keep the learning approach and not studying approach, we have to become the jack of all and not master of one. Yeah, because this is learning and not studying. All right. So these are the points I wanted to share. Now, to make the discussion more relevant and specific, I would like you to ask me about your reading problem so that we can try to solve them immediately. So Umang, people who want to ask questions, we can open up.
If there will be questions, I would suggest all of them to come out with some questions. Right? You can ask questions. You can ask questions here in Zoom, but I will ask questions here. You can raise your hand here, which you can keep your questions here.
Yeah, and at the same time, I am keeping an eye on the YouTube comments. If people ask some... अरे बाप रे, 10 बुक्स उतना तो, बट ऑफ कोर्स, या आई थिंक द इजी आंसर इज दैट व्हाट एवर बुक्स आई कवर ऑन बुकलेट ऐप आर सो फिल्टर्ड एंड दे आर सो रेलेवेंट फॉर डे टू डे लाइफ, लाइक रिलेशनशिप्स, यू नो द प्रॉब्लम्स इन रिलेशनशिप्स, द the stress management or the mobile distraction, the most serious issue nowadays. So how to deal with technologies and distractions. ये सब books मैं करता हूँ. My personal favorite is Start With Why by Simon Sinek. Okay, I must read for everybody. Start With Why by Simon Sinek. Okay, somebody, can I take one question from YouTube? Umang?
Yeah.
So, somebody is asking how to increase the reading speed. Yeah, this is another common question that I am... Okay. So, now there are two things... Yeah. Cool. See, again, normal reading speed is 150 to 200 words per minute on an average people can read. I have increased to 1200 words per minute. But that's not the key. Okay. Completing a book has got two aspects. 80 or 70% is your approach towards a book. Okay. You have to create a sense of urgency to finish the book, even at the cost of comprehension and retention. I will be surprised to hear this. Arre, without comprehension, matlab kuch samjha nahi, phir bhi padhte jane ka? How foolish is that? Right? Yeah. But trust me, again, I am saying we are not going to be tested on this information that we are going to learn from the author. The only question in my mind when I open a book, the only curiosity I have is that what is that something that this author knows that I don't know? That's all. Right? If you think something is repetitive, just skip it. ऐसा कोई रूल नहीं है कि चैप्टर नंबर 1 से ही शुरू करना है as far as non-fiction books are concerned. So what I do is I first go to the index and check the topics. One topic that is so exciting to me or something wow, something new which I don't know, I'll straight away jump to that chapter number 5. And then I'll read the first paragraph and straight away jump to the last paragraph of the chapter. Because authors have the tendency to summarize the chapter in the last paragraph. अगर इन दोनों पैराग्राफ में से अगर मुझे कुछ समझा नहीं या कुछ नया मुझे लगा जो शॉकिंग है, एक्साइटिंग है, then I will read the chapter in detail. Again, second point is the author tries to highlight some parts of the book through bold, italics, boxing the text, है ना? तो हम उसको ध्यान ही नहीं देते. The author is shouting that ये ज्यादा important है, इसका मतलब क्या? बाकी का इतना important नहीं है. पर हमारे हमको क्या सिखाया गया? You have to read word to word. Yeah? Slowly पढ़ोगे तो ज्यादा समझता है. No, it's a myth. हमको गलत सिखाया गया है कि slow पढ़ोगे तो ज्यादा समझता है. जब आप slow पढ़ते हो तो problem क्या है? Our brain works much faster than our eyes. And when we read slowly, the brain feels in FM पे FM लगाते हैं, इधर उधर देखते हैं, अरे वो गाड़ी में कौन बैठा है, ये सब टाइम पास करते हैं. But when you are driving at the speed of 120, we don't dare to even look here and there. We are so focused, right? At times I even switch off the music when I'm at the speed of 120. That means speed is a very good friend of concentration. When you read faster, the chances of wandering off or daydreaming and dozing off are almost zero. Okay, so this is one part to changing the approach. The technical part of increasing your reading speed is taught by Tony Buzan. He is the father of speed reading and mind maps. I have included that in detail in my book as well. But time will be very short to discuss the technical part. But it's a skill, not a talent. Everybody can increase their reading speed. If not 1200, but at least 800, 900 through practice. I took 8 months to increase my reading speed from 150 to 1200 words per minute. See, reading is reading. Even जो summaries बना रहा हो, voracious reader है, वो बोलते कि भाई हमको summary मत दो, हमसे book का नाम दो, we'll manage anyway to read. But unfortunately, 90% people are non-readers और उनके लिए booklet बनाया है. 90% in booklet community are non-readers. 10% are voracious readers. So you can use the summaries as a filtration process to arrive at a book which you like. Yeah, I think this is a very valid and relevant question. Very, very important question. I really thank to the person who asked this question. I've read more than 25 books on time management and learned that there is nothing called time management. There is only attention management. And attention management is primarily distraction management. Alright? there are two types of distractions, external distraction and internal distraction. External मतलब मैं कुछ फोकस काम कर रहा हूँ, एक्सेल शीट पे काम कर रहा हूँ, पावर पॉइंट पे या बुक पढ़ रहा हूँ, और कोई आके मेरे सर पे मारता है, अरे अमृत चलना चाय पीने. That is external distraction. But that is only 20% of the total distractions. तो उसको ज्यादा अहमियत नहीं देंगे. Remaining 80% distraction is internal. Like I am working on the Excel sheet और वो टिंग बज गया मेरे फोन पे. That टिंग is worse than a craving of cigarette. Right? वो जब टिंग बजता है और भी जब मैं हाथ का काम छोड़ता हूँ, अरे चल ना उमंग का सिर्फ हाय आया ना, उसके हाय को रिप्लाई देता हूँ. राइट? अरे वो कुछ वीडियो भेजा है क्या? फिर वो हाय भेजने के बाद नीचे दिखता है कि अरे कुछ कोरोना वायरस पे वीडियो है, चल वो देख लेता हूँ. एंड इन द वो एक मैसेज टाइम ऑन व्हाट्सएप, नेटफ्लिक्स, यूट्यूब, जितना लोग करते. बट द डिफरेंस इज स्टिल माय प्रोडक्टिविटी मस्ट बी मच हायर देन अदर्स, इज दैट आई विल रिप्लाई टू योर मैसेज व्हेन आई वांट एंड नॉट व्हेन यू वांट. जब तुम मुझे मैसेज करोगे, माय मोबाइल विल बी इन द अदर रूम, आई वोंट बी इवन हियरिंग द टिंग. Right? And then when I take a break after 30 minutes, I'll reply to your message. And this makes lot of difference in your productivity. All right? It's not about how much time you spend on WhatsApp. It is when, the timing of spending on WhatsApp. The timing should not be in between your focused work. Aap agar 15 minute bhi focused kaam karoge chalega, then take a micro break of 2 minutes and check all your missed calls, check all your WhatsApps. सबको रिप्लाई दो, वापस रूम दूसरे रूम में मोबाइल रखो और काम करो. कीपिंग योर मोबाइल इन योर पॉकेट और ऑन योर डेस्क एंड वर्किंग एंड ट्राइंग टू फोकस ऑन योर वर्क इज इनविटेशन टू अनहैप्पीनेस. या एनी मोर क्वेश्चन? अगेन दिस इज अगेन गोइंग टू हैबिट नंबर वन, वी आर टेकिंग इट टू सीरियसली, है ना. आई मीन सलमान खान का मूवी अच्छा होता है या शाहरुख खान का होता है, जो अच्छा है वो अच्छा है. राइट? यू नेवर नो. सो एज आई सेड, देयर इज ऑफ कोर्स वी कांट जज द बुक बाय इट्स कवर, बट जज द बुक आफ्टर रीडिंग 10 पेजेस. 10 पेजेस तो पढ़ सकते हो. राइट? और अभी टू जज अ बुक यू डोंट हैव टू बाय इट और यू डोंट हैव टू टेक द बुक इन योर हैंड्स. यू गो टू यूट्यूब, मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑथर्स टॉक अबाउट देयर बुक. अगर वो टॉपिक अच्छा लगा, वो ऑथर का दिमाग अच्छा लगा, उसके रिसर्च अच्छा लगा, देन यू कैन लैंड ऑन द बुक. Okay. I can take Kirti Panchal's question. She is asking, sir, please answer what is the difference between reading a book and listening a book. अच्छा, तो reading has now expanded. It's reading मतलब सिर्फ reading नहीं, अभी listening भी हो गया है. अभी because reading takes a little willpower. अगर आप थके हुए, already exhausted in the office, तो at that time you can just sit back and listen to audio book summaries on booklet or audible or podcast. Right? Listening takes less willpower than reading. In fact, काफी booklet में मेरे को लोगों ने बताया कि we read and listen both at the same time. And they said that we are able to digest more when I read and listen both at the same time. Maybe because we are using two senses, eyes and ears, at the same time, तो ज्यादा digestion होता है. Come on. That is just a stupid medium to transfer the great thoughts of the author into me. So it could be a mobile app or a hard copy or anything. Very good. So one of the habits, it's habit number 6, read and pass it on. The best way to do just a hui hai, right? Are mere pura to pura ghar bura hua hai, main agar dunga to bhi bachenge, because my whole life is for books and I am reading for India. So my reading is definitely, any of these I have borrowed, they are not my own, they are borrowed from people or gifted by people. So just read and pass it on. Don't keep it to yourself. Okay? Even if you read my book, I want you to read it and pass it on. That is one of the main habits amongst all the 7. So abhi baat chhedi hai, to I'll just tell you two things, unique things about this book. I believe in unselfishness. I have picked up one human value to live my life, and that's unselfishness. So I have not copyrighted this book. I believe copywriting or patenting is selfishness. So and the ideas in this book are a gift to the humankind to take it forward. Second thing, I get hundreds and thousands of mails and messages from young boys and girls who say that we can't afford to buy books, but we love reading. So, main unko bolta tha ki arre wo booklet app download karo, sab free hai, enjoy. And you know, Umang, what they used to say? They used to say that we have read all your booklets. We are desperately waiting for your next upload. and my heart melted for such passionate but poor readers. I had no answer for them. But now that I have written my own book, I have a very good answer for them. So what I do is I appeal to people who can afford, who are above the poverty line, and I have kept a certain price for this book, and I'll share the link to buy the book after the video is uploaded on YouTube. Okay. Yeah. So I appeal to everybody that you help me so that I can help these poor kids who are passionate but poor readers, like so kind of Robin Hood of books, right? Where you can help me so that I can help them by giving the book for free at no cost. Yeah, so I've created categories like relationships, yeah, habits and self-improvement, then mobile addiction. ऐसे मैंने कुछ categories create किए हैं, biographies, inspirational stories. Yeah, catch here, you will not get that category the moment you download the app. So what I've done is I've come out with a new idea called Reading IQ. Reading IQ is the more you keep reading on the app, आपका IQ बढ़ता जाएगा. And you'll be getting some surprises in the form of privileges. Your app will get better and better as you improve your IQ. Like 10 का IQ हो गया तो उसका उस बंदे का booklet app अलग रहेगा. जिसका IQ 50 है उसका booklet app अलग रहेगा. Right? So you will be creating and building your own app as you read more and more. So this is one way of motivating you to more. Yeah. So next time we can have a session where we can keep a condition ki aapka IQ 10 hai, you can join our session.
Sure.
Verbally, no, never read loudly because it reduces your speed. It's always in your mind. Never read loudly. Unless you want to practice your speaking ability, public speaking, to fir theek hai. But never read loudly.
Achha, what about the hard topics?
Very good point. जितने भी बुक्स मुझे मिलते हैं ना, बोरो करता हूं मैं, तो मुझे दिखता है कि डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स को अंडरलाइन करते हैं वो. लेट मी मेक इट वेरी क्लियर, योर प्राइमरी ऑब्जेक्टिव शुड नेवर बी टू इंप्रूव वोकैबुलरी व्हाइल रीडिंग अ बुक. वो मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव नहीं है. सी, वोकैबुलरी, गुड वोकैबुलरी जस्ट अ बाय प्रोडक्ट ऑफ रीडिंग हैबिट. डोंट रेफर टू डिक्शनरी एवरी नाउ एंड देन. आपको वोकैबुलरी इंप्रूव करने के लिए रीड नहीं करना है बुक को. आपको वो ऑथर से कुछ सीखना है, नए थॉट्स, नए आइडियाज, राइट, क्रिएटिव आइडियाज, वो सीखना है. तो बहुत बार क्या होता है, कोई नया वर्ड आपको दिखा तो थोड़ा अंदाज आता है कि वो लाइन या सेंटेंस का कंस्ट्रक्शन से समझ में आता है कि ये इसका मतलब क्या है, राइट. अभी कितने लोगों को क्वारंटाइन वर्ड का मीनिंग मालूम था इसके पहले? किसी को नहीं मालूम रहेगा. और किसी ने डिक्शनरी रेफर भी नहीं किया होगा, फिर भी हमको पता चला ना क्वारंटाइन का मतलब क्या है, राइट, बिकॉज वी फाउंड आउट द मीनिंग बाय अदर other sentences around that word. So I'm not against referring dictionary, right? एक 200-300 book pages के book में एक 10 बार आपने dictionary refer किया, it's okay, I can understand. But हर बार मत करो, because that will stop your momentum. और फिर आपको लगेगा अरे ये book तो खत्म ही नहीं हो रही है. और book खत्म नहीं हो रही है तो आपको guilty लगेगा कि you are a bad reader, you are a slow reader. So again I am saying, keep the urgency to finish the book, even at the cost of comprehension, even at the cost of retention, even at the cost of vocabulary. Yeah, I think we don't understand the power of accumulated knowledge. Because unfortunately, वो accumulated knowledge दिखता नहीं हमको. See, अभी जब मैं मेरा first book पढ़ा था, आज मेरा 1350वां book मैं पढ़ रहा हूँ, उसमें बहुत फर्क है. क्योंकि उसमें इतना knowledge accumulate हुआ है कि 1350वां book मेरा यूं हो जाएगा खत्म. क्योंकि कहीं ना कहीं link लगेगा, right? So don't try to read the same book again and again. Just expose yourself to as many books as you can. Even if you half leave it half read, that's absolutely fine, right? Just keep on going, because uska fayda aapko long run mein milega. The problem with reading is like exercising. Aap ek hafta gym mein jaoge to aapko six packs nahi aane wale, wo charbi waise hi rehne wali hai. When you keep going to the gym again and again and again, after 2-3 years thoda bahut kuch shape mein aata hai body, right? Same is the case with reading. आपको एक बुक पढ़ के आप चाणक्य नहीं बनने वाले हो. जितना आप ज्यादा बुक्स पढ़ोगे, इवन इफ यू डोंट रीड वर्ड टू वर्ड, एब्सोल्युटली फाइन, दैट्स एब्सोल्युटली फाइन, राइट. बट गेट एक्सपोज टू एज मेनी बुक्स एज यू कैन एंड रीड रैंडम. मैंने बहुत लोगों को देखा कि मैं बस हैरी पॉटर पढ़ती हूं, मैं बस सिडनी शेल्डन पढ़ती हूं, मुझे सिर्फ सेल्फ हेल्प वाले बुक्स अच्छे लगते हैं. ऐसा मत करो, मैंने ये गलती की थी. अब अभी इस वक्त आपके घर पे कुछ ना कुछ बुक्स पड़े रहेंगे, आई एम वेरी श्योर किसी के घर में 10 बुक्स पड़े हैं, किसी घर में 50 बुक्स पड़े रहेंगे। जस्ट टेल मी विथ 100% ऑनेस्टी, दिल पे हाथ रख के बताओ मुझे, किसी ने जितने भी घर पे बुक्स अभी पड़े आपके वो सब पढ़ लिया आपने? ऐसा कोई? आई एम गारंटी, राइट? सो व्हाट डू आई मीन, व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेल यू इज रीडिंग, घर के बुक्स पढ़ो, सब खत्म करो, फिर बात करो। हाँ, वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन अगेन। नाउ दोज हु डोंट हैव द ऐप एंड दे गो होम एंड डाउनलोड द ऐप टुडे, जैसे मैंने बोला कि मैंने 250 बुक्स का समरी बनाया है अब तक, इफ यू इंस्टॉल द ऐप टुडे एंड आई डंप ऑल दोज 250 बुक्स इन योर मोबाइल, आई बेट यू विल नॉट रीड एनी ऑफ देम, गारंटी। यू नो व्हाई? अबंडेंस इज द एनिमी ऑफ मोटिवेशन। जब बहुत कुछ हमको मिलता है ना इतना सारा, तो हमको इतनी मस्ती आती है ना। जस्ट रिमेंबर स्कैनिंग दोज टीवी चैनल्स जस्ट बिकॉज दे आर सो मेनी एंड एंड ऑफ वॉचिंग नथिंग। 300-350 चैनल है ना, चेंज करते रहो, कुछ देखते नहीं हम, राइट? हेंस आई से दैट अबंडेंस इज द एनिमी ऑफ मोटिवेशन। मैंने जानबूझ के वो लिस्ट में कभी नहीं दूंगा आपको, मैं वो 250 बुक्स का लिस्ट कभी नहीं दूंगा, क्योंकि वो फिर सी वी थिंक दैट वी लव चॉइसेस, बट व्हेन वी गेट टू मेनी चॉइसेस वी डोंट चूज, वी जस्ट यू नो कीप शफलिंग, हम देखते रहते जैसे टीवी चैनल देखते रहते। सो अबंडेंस इज द एनिमी ऑफ मोटिवेशन, इसलिए मैंने क्या किया है, एक आइडिया डाला है बुक में, रीड वन गेट वन। एक बुक पढ़ो, बुकलेट पढ़ो, वो पूरा पढ़ने के बाद यू विल गेट द न्यू वन, सो इट इज लाइक अ रिवॉर्ड। वो एक लोगो नाचने लगता है इफ यू कंप्लीट इट 100% एंड दैट बुकलेट लोगो स्टार्ट्स डांसिंग एंड यू आर एलिजिबल टू डाउनलोड अ न्यू बुकलेट ऑफ योर चॉइस, एंड वन, देयर इज नो लिमिट टू इट, बट वन एट अ टाइम। वाओ, दिस इज अगेन, आई थिंक यू आर गेटिंग अमेजिंग एंड स्मार्ट क्वेश्चंस। आई वाज एक्सपेक्टिंग दिस क्वेश्चन बिकॉज आई वाज वेरी डेस्परेट टू आंसर इट। ओके, बहुत लोग बोलते हैं कि मैं बुक्स पढ़ता हूं पर उसका जिंदगी में एप्लीकेशन नहीं होता है, उसका इंप्लीमेंटेशन नहीं होता है। लेट मी टेल यू दैट लर्निंग एंड डूइंग आर नॉट टू डिफरेंट फेजेस। ऐसा अलग अलग फेज नहीं है कि फर्स्ट आई विल लर्न देन आई विल डू। डू यू से दैट आई एम लर्निंग पियानो देन आई विल प्ले पियानो, ऐसा होता है कभी? नहीं होता है ना। यू लर्न एंड यू प्ले, एवरीथिंग इज सेम, राइट? बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली इन आवर एजुकेशन सिस्टम we are asked to learn in four walls of a classroom for 10 years 15 years and then go out and apply and do it. Aisa nahi hota hai. You learn while you do, and when you do you make mistakes, and it is impossible to learn without mistakes. So aisa nahi hai ki aapko book padha abhi aapko mujhe apply karna hai, aisa nahi hai. You live the book even if you have not completed it. Ek koi idea aapko acha laga, humko lagta hai ki are wo hamare life mein hota nahi hai, wo alag cheez hai, right? For example, I read one line from a book called The 4-Hour Work Week by Tim Ferriss. The author says that we expand our work to fill up the time available to complete it. I repeat, we expand our work to fill up the time available to complete it. Abhi ye idea was in the context of office work, right? Ki hum pura din kitna hai, us hisab se hum hamare kaam ko badhate hain. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर एग्जाम के लिए 4 महीने बाकी है तो एक चैप्टर करने के लिए हमको 10 दिन लगते हैं, पर अगर एग्जाम कल है तो वही चैप्टर हमारा 1 घंटे में हो जाता है। नाउ दिस वाज द आइडिया। नाउ आई यूज दिस आइडिया इन जिम। मैं जिम में जाता था, मेरे 2-2 घंटे उधर जाते थे और खास कुछ एक्सरसाइज नहीं होता था, तो आई लर्न दैट मैं वो 2 घंटे फिलअप करने के लिए जा रहा हूँ, किसी से बातें कर रहा हूँ, व्हाट्सएप पे टाइम पास कर रहा हूँ, थोड़ा बहुत एक्सरसाइज कर रहा हूँ। व्हेन आई पुट अ टाइमर कि 45 सेकेंड्स मेरे को एक्सरसाइज करना है, 23 सेकेंड्स रेस्ट लेना है, वापस 45 सेकेंड्स एक्सरसाइज करना है, 23 सेकेंड्स रेस्ट लेना है, लिटरली 2 घंटे का एक्सरसाइज 20 मिनट्स में होने लगा। नाउ सी हाउ आई अप्लाइड दैट आइडिया व्हिच वाज अंडर द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ ऑफिस, आई यूज इट इन द जिम, राइट? सो आई वुड हैव लव्ड इफ माय टीचर हु टॉट मी ट्रिग्नोमेट्री व्हेन आई वाज इन 8th स्टैंडर्ड हु साइन कॉस थीटा इफ यू हैव शी वुड हैव टेकन मी टू द nearby flyover which is under construction and told me, Amrut, sin cos theta yahan use hota hai, agar sin cos theta nahi hota to ye bridge would have collapsed. I would have loved to learn trigonometry more. Yeah, so doing is learning, nothing is theoretical. Ye jo koi bolta na ki ye to bookish knowledge hai, theoretical knowledge, let me tell you, there is nothing theoretical in this life. Har cheez jo book mein kahin na kahin apply ho raha hai. Okay, trigonometry, sin cos theta abhi is waqt mere career mein use nahi ho raha hai, पर कहीं ना कहीं हो रहा है। ब्रिजेस एंड फ्लाईओवर्स बनाने में साइन कॉस थीटा यूज हो रहा है. E is equal to mc square by law of relativity by Albert Einstein is not used by me in booklet, but it is used by Google in Google Maps, isn't it? There is nothing called theoretical, everything is practical. I'll tell you simple, Umang, if you decide to write a book tomorrow, won't you put all your experiences of your life? तो कौन सी बुक थ्योरेटिकल होगी, हर बुक प्रैक्टिकल ही होगी ना, राइट? थैंक यू, थैंक यू सो मच, मजा आ गया. आई होप आई डिड जस्टिस टू योर एंड आई मेट योर एक्सपेक्टेशंस, एंड दोस क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वी डिड नॉट एड्रेस, प्लीज राइट इट एज अ कमेंट ऑन यूट्यूब एंड आई विल बी हैप्पी टू आंसर दोस क्वेश्चंस. सो हैप्पी रीडिंग एंड एंजॉय द लॉकडाउन. चलो या बाय बाय गाइज एंड थैंक यू उमंग, बाय.
Yeah,
thank you.